Hi, welcome to another episode of my Small Business Entrepreneur video series. My name is John Edmonds. Today, I want to talk about how to make a sales presentation. When you have a shop, selling is relatively easy. People come in, choose what they want to buy, maybe with a bit of a help from a salesperson, and then they make a purchase. If you have a trades business, such as a plumber, electrician and the like, you have usually placed your advertising in such a way that people ring up and ask for your services, or you obtain customers through word of mouth or regular customers. However, when you have a service business, like a web designer, architect, marketer and the like, sometimes you have to go out to the client's place of work and make a sales presentation. And that's what I want to discuss in this video. Like public speaking, most people don't like making presentations, but it's one of the most effective ways to get your business message across, and generally better than a mail shot or waiting for people to call you after you've placed an advert in a paper. You ring up potential customers and ask for an opportunity to make a sales presentation, either to the chief executive or other appropriate executives. In another video, I talk about how to actually call clients to ask for the 30 minutes to make a presentation, so I won't go into that here. I'll assume that you've already made appointments for you to make a presentation. There are three stages to a sales presentation: the preparation, the presentation delivery, and handling client questions. In respect to preparation, the first thing you need to ask yourself is, what message are you trying to get across? Are you seeking to create interest, or are you going for a complete sell, or are you simply demonstrating your product or service? The second thing to think about is who your audience is and what their needs are going to be. For example, if you're selling a product, then a senior executive might be more interested in the price, whereas a person lower down the company hierarchy might be more interested in the technical details and functionality. Thirdly, how much time do you have to make the presentation? My guess is that they'll give you around 5 to 10 minutes. And if it goes on any longer than their expectations, they'll get bored. One thing is for sure, that you must not exceed the time allowed, and you should ask the audience in advance, if you can, how much time is actually allowed. Fourthly comes the structure of the presentation, and in today's world, doing a PowerPoint presentation may not be the way to go. I had to do a presentation recently at a university, and they were quite explicit that PowerPoint should not be used, and I think this is because people have seen enough of them and want something a bit more original and a bit more personal. They want to see products, and they want to see it working if possible. Nowadays, a set of slides can simply put people off. In developing your presentation, one thing you might consider is using a catchphrase of your brand, if you have one, and work your presentation around that. You might even start and finish with the catchphrase. In another video, I talk about selling, and I discuss the idea of talking in sentences that explain features, advantages, and benefits of your product or service, all in one sentence and in that order. For example, the buttons on this amplifier are positioned in a unique configuration so that you can tune the sound to your own ears. If you break that sentence down that I've just said, then the buttons on the amplifier are the feature, the positioning of the buttons is the advantage, and being able to tune the sound to your own ears is the benefit. Listen again. The buttons on this amplifier are positioned in a unique configuration so that you can tune the sound to your own ears. Features, advantages, and benefits. Get it? It's one of the most effective ways to sell, because it isn't a con. It's an honest sales technique that gives the customer all the knowledge they need to know about the product or service. Therefore, you need to make these sentences up about your product or service by examining the features, working out what the end benefits are, and there will be some, and then converting that into what it means to the customer. You see, what the customer wants to know all the time throughout your presentation is what's in it for me, meaning me, the person who's in the audience, personally. When I used to run a chain of casual fashion stores in Australia, where the weather gets quite hot, I used to teach sales staff to say things like, this t-shirt is made of 100% cotton, which is the feature, and the cotton breathes, which is the advantage, so you'll feel cool in hot weather, which is the benefit. When opening your sales presentation, there are 9 things you have to do, and these are. Start with a greeting. Say something like, good morning and thank you for coming. Secondly, acknowledge the audience by saying something like, it's nice to see so many smiling faces. You don't have to be exact, by the way, what I'm saying here, just this is the kind of thing to do. Thirdly, tell them who you are. Say something like, just for the benefit of those who don't know me, I'm, and then you go on to tell them what you are. Fourth, tell them what you're going to say. Say something like, this morning I'm going to explain. Fifth, tell them why you're here. Say something like, I hope that today I'll be able to show you the complete benefits of investing in my products. Sixth, tell them how long you'll speak for. Say something like, I plan to speak for around X amount of minutes. Seventh, tell them how you're going to present your talk. And you say something like, my talk today will be divided into 3 areas. Eighth, tell them what they have to do if they have any questions. And this is where you'd say something like, please keep your questions until the end of my talk. And then finally, 9, tell them anything else that they have to do while you're talking. For example, you might say something like, I recommend you take a few notes. So that's the first 9 steps to opening a presentation. I'm not going to play it back, but if you play it back, you'll see that your opening is about 90 words long, and it will take you about 30 seconds, but it covers the 9 topics in 1 hit. Next time you listen to any kind of professional speaker, you can see the ones who've been trained in the 9 steps of opening and those who haven't. You need to put your presentation together so that you are presenting a logical argument for your product or service. And they want to hear facts rather than fiction. It's always a good idea to include testimonials from other customers so that you're presenting a third-party viewpoint, and particularly if the testimonial is from somebody that the client may admire, such as another large company or a celebrity. You certainly need to think about any questions that the audience might ask and be ahead of them by addressing them in your presentation. When I used to teach senior managers in Sweden how to make presentations in English within the European Union, I used to give them this phrase which explains presentations perfectly. Tell them what you're going to tell them, then tell them, then tell them what you told them. That's the sort of the 3 steps. What this means is that the core of your presentation should really be in 3 parts. The opening is where you explain what you're going to talk about. Then you talk about it. Then you go over the main points as a conclusion. It's one of the best frameworks I know for making almost any type of presentation. Here's a few more important tips. Firstly, write out a script, then practice it, then bullet point the points onto cards or an iPad, and then throw away the script. Reading from a script never works, or very rarely works, so don't do it. Secondly, if you need to use a projector or laptop or overhead screen, find out well in advance if the client has these and get prior permission to use them. If they don't, then you'll need to take your own and you need to practice putting it together fairly quickly. Thirdly, practice your presentation in front of a mirror for at least 3 days in advance, and even better if in front of friends and family, and listen carefully to any feedback that they might give you. Make any adjustments for improvement. Fourth, visual aids such as photos and videos work very, very well in a presentation. So take along free samples and do anything where you can get the audience to interact. Again, I remember back when I was in Sweden, where I was training managers how to make presentations, and one senior manager of an international organization put a presentation together where she incorporated all of the five senses of touch, taste, hearing, sight and smell. And it was actually one of the best presentations I've ever seen. So you might take something from that. If you can incorporate people's five senses, it might work for you. Fifth, recognize the audience. As you talk, make sure you mention some of the names of the key people. People get turned on by hearing their own name in front of others and being recognized. Sixth, use eye contact. And there's a special way to do this, particularly if you've got quite a lot of people. Constantly scan the audience and make eye contact frequently. If there's a lot of people, then split the room into quarters and take one quarter and then move to the next and cover the room every minute or so. Seventh, make sure you use positive body language. Be enthusiastic and don't be afraid to use your arms and get passionate about what you're talking about. Of course, you'll need to speak clearly and keep your head up and project your voice. Eighth, organize handouts where you can and make sure your business card is attached. Ninth, arrange to arrive at least 15 minutes early for the presentation. And wait outside for a few minutes so you have time to relax and calm down. Being late for your presentation is an absolute no-no because you will be stressed and you'll stuff it up. Finally, let me just talk about closing your presentation. First, give a clear signal that you're about to end. Use words like, and finally. Secondly, summarize what you have presented. This is where you tell them what you told them. Third, make your conclusions or recommendations if appropriate. Fourth, indicate that the presentation has ended by saying something like, that concludes my presentation for today. Fifth, invite questions, comments, feedback or further discussions, whatever is appropriate for you. Sixth, answer questions or use diversion tactics. Seven, thank the audience for attending. And finally, eighth, stop talking. Don't do what some people do by finishing the presentation and then going back into the presentation saying something like, oh, by the way, I forgot to mention. That's a no-no. If you do your homework in compiling a sales presentation, you can put something together that sounds very professional. The more professional it is, the more confident you'll feel and the more impressed the customer is likely to be. Not only about your products and services, but about your professionalism of you and your company as a whole. So thank you for watching. I trust you found the information in this video helpful.